This conference will now be recorded.
Welcome to the Alpena City Council meeting of February 9th. Please call to order.
Mayor Johnson?
Here.
Councilmember Kane?
Here.
Councilmember Mitchell?
Here.
And Mayor Pro Tem Nowak?
Here.
Please.
Walchek is excused.
And she is excused. Please rise for the flag. I pledge allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Any approval of the agenda?
I move we approve the agenda as presented.
Support.
Mayor Johnson?
Yes.
Councilmember Kane?
Yes.
Councilmember Mitchell?
Yes.
And Mayor Pro Tem Nowak?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Are there any modifications to the agenda this evening?
Not for me.
Approval of the minutes from the last meeting. Any issues?
No issues.
Okay. Public comment. Citizens appearing before council on agenda and non-agenda items shall be allowed a maximum of 5 minutes each to address their concerns. This is the only time during council meeting that citizens are allowed to address the council. Please come to the podium and state your name and address. Online comments will be accepted after in-person comments are completed. All comments should be directed to the council and not the audience. No clapping, cheering, or yelling is allowed. Thank you.
Good evening. Kevin Ginter, 390 South Lawn, Alpena. I was a witness to city government in action at the Planning Commission meeting, which I enjoyed the discussion about, I'm assuming he lives in the city, but renovating a property from a single family to a duplex, I believe it was up and down. And after a lot of the discussion, rightfully so, it sounded like that the group considered the way the ordinance was written. And to me, the elephant in the room was the paved surface when it became a rental. And I just brought that up in the public comment to maybe if you're looking at housing, trying to create these opportunities for people to make these improvements and put properties up for rent. Maybe you put this on, however this happens, put this paved surface thing on hiatus for whatever you would deem 5 or 10 years or something, if that's the time needed to create these opportunities. Because if the property wasn't a rental, they wouldn't have to have this paved surface. All right, thanks.
Thank you. Anyone else online? We have no public hearing. Consent agenda. Bills to be allowed in the amount of $538,875.67 and authorize Mayor Johnson and Clerk Soik to sign the warrant. Appoint Mayor Pro Tem Nowak to the Alpena County Central Dispatch Board and Councilmember Kane as an alternate. C, approve the Americans with Disability Act contract with Disability Network Northern Michigan and authorize Mayor Johnson and Clerk Treasurer Finance Director Soik to sign, and council reappointment of Keith Wallace as the assistant city attorney for a 2-year term expiring on February 19th, 2026.
I move we approve the consent agenda as presented.
Second.
Councilmember Kane?
Yes.
Councilmember Mitchell?
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Nowak?
Yes.
And Mayor Johnson?
Yes.
Motion carried.
And under presentations, we have Montiel Birmingham, Planning and Zoning Development Director, and she is going to do an introduction of Chris Hatch, our building inspector.
Evening. So I just wanted to take a minute to introduce Chris Hatch. Chris is our new building inspector with the city. Chris is replacing Steve Hall, who you're familiar with and have worked with for a few years. Chris had over 10 years of experience with his residential builder's license and worked for Omni for over 20 years. So we're excited to have him on board. He's getting ready to take all of the tests with the state that he needs to take to be a building inspector and plan reviewer. So If you have any questions, you are always more than welcome to reach out to me and now to Chris as well.
Thank you. Thank you. So I say it's an honor and a privilege to be a part of this team, and I look forward to working with them to maintain the safety and beauty of our city, Alpena. Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome. Thank you. Announcements. A, early voting is available now through Sunday, February 25th, 2024, in the council chambers at City Hall from 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. B, the Clerk Treasurer's Office will be open on Saturday, February 24th, 2024, from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. for voters to register to vote and request an absentee ballot. Payments will also be accepted. There will be a special joint Council and Planning Commission meeting on February 22nd, 2024 at 5:30 p.m. in Council Chambers at City Hall. We're down to report of officers. So, Bill.
Good evening, council members. This is first reading of ordinances 24-500 and 24-501. There's a brief memo in here from Montiel that indicated both of these were approved at the Planning Commission meeting on February 12th. So ordinance number 24-500 states as follows: the City of Alpena zoning ordinance map is hereby amended to provide the parcel located at 907 Merchant Street additionally rezoned from R-2 to R-T to allow for the legal use of the property as a duplex. And the owner statement of conditions is that it will convert the residence from a single family dwelling to a duplex. Section 2 is a severability clause. Section 3 is a savings clause. Section 4 is the effective date. And this is just first reading, so if there's any proposed changes, just let us know and we'll change it before it comes back in 2 weeks.
Anyone have any questions on that? Okay. And then Bill, first reading ordinance 24-502.
Yeah, ordinance 24-502 states that the City of Alpena zoning ordinance map is hereby amended as follows: the parcel located at 511 Long Lake Avenue shall be conditionally rezoned from R-2 to R-T to allow for the legal use of the property as a duplex. The owner statement of conditions that will be converting the residence from a single family dwelling to a duplex. Section 2 is a severability clause. Section 3 is a savings clause. Section 4 is the effective date. Once again, it's the first reading, so if there's any proposed changes, just let me know.
As a correction, this is ordinance 24-501. I think you introduced as 502.
I said 502?
I think so.
No, I did. And the reason I did is because, can somebody tell me if in our packet we have a paper for the retirement committee. It's
502.
Yeah, that's
it.
Yeah,
there is three of them, but 500 and 501.
Oh,
yeah, 501.
Okay. Okay.
I speak.
Okay, Bill. The next one. Does anyone have any questions on?
No.
And 501? No, ma'am.
No. Okay, section 62 to 92 on the retirement allowance.
So this is ordinance number 24-502, be it ordained by the Municipal Council of the City of Alpena, State of Michigan as follows: Chapter 62, Article 3, Division 1, Section 62-92 of the Code of Ordinances of the City of Alpena is hereby repealed in full and replaced with the following language. So A, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 are just the retirement options that are available to retirees. The main change is under B, which says that all members of the retirement system, whether covered by a labor agreement or otherwise, may elect to withdraw their accumulated contribution in a lump sum at retirement. The regular retirement benefit will be reduced by the actuarial equivalent of the withdrawal utilizing the PBGC replacement rate, as more fully described below. I think, as council knows, PBGC no longer publishes the rate, so we had to develop a new rate. The only change from the previous ordinance is that there was some misunderstanding as to what the minus 2 months meant. And so we The one we passed last year was using the November rate. And after Louise Gates, our actuary, and John Clerk, our labor attorney, went through it again, we thought there should be this amendment to make sure that it's consistent with the October rate. And the October rate is the rate that we've always applied in the past. So this just basically cleans up the change from the November, using the month of November as the starting month to change it to the month of October. And this is just first reading, so if there's any changes, let me know.
Is there, is number two supposed to read October as well?
Number two where? I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, there are a lot of number twos. Under B. Two, where it says the immediate annuity rate.
And then each January.
What page? It's really hard to find.
There's no page number, so.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's on page 23 of the document, of the packet.
Actually, I think you're correct. That's, I believe that should, well, yes. It should say, it should have initially said October 2021. So that says November 2021, which is what we had passed before. But if you go down for determining the interest rate for December of 2022, we've changed step one. Used to say, or did say before, November 2022.
Okay.
It's October 2022 now.
So this is?
Yes.
Correct. Okay.
Okay.
And then it says the rates for all future years will follow the formula unless amended. So the new formula has the October month in versus the November month in.
Does anyone have any questions on that?
No
questions.
No questions.
Okay, this will come back next time for second reading. Now we're down to.
Yep.
I move we adjourn to closed session to discuss an update regarding pending litigation in the Max Tribunal of KAHV. LLC versus the City of Alpena, and an update on sewer and water litigation, and an update regarding litigation in the Michigan Tax Tribunal for the City of Alpena versus the County of Alpena.
Board.
Councilmember Mitchell?
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Nowak?
Yes.
Mayor Johnson?
Yes.
And Councilmember Kane?
Yes.
Motion carries.
When she says, I'm waiting for Johnson.
It's right there. So if I ever blur out, yes. Or say no, you're going to vote yes.
No.